Let us now try to understand the difference between writing the logic of a problem using a pseudocode versus an algorithm by the means of an example. There are already lectures which have been developed to help you understand what is an algorithm. Okay, it's Introduction to Algorithms Part 1, Part 2 and Part 3. I recommend you refer to them to understand what is an algorithm. But just to refresh, an algorithm is simply a problem-solving process which is used not only in computer science to write programs but also in daily life. It is nothing but it's a series of instructions in order to solve a problem or to get to the solution of the problem. Now, this is a problem. I have adapted it from a course called CS50 by David Malan at Harvard University. Okay, this problem I have slightly twisted it so that you understand it better. Suppose we have 50 students in a class and we want to write the logic to find out how many students are absent. So one way to solve this problem is I can go into the class. First I'll say total number of students is 50. Let me say initialize absent to 0. Initialize present also to 0. Then what I can do is, for every student I see, increase the present count to present count plus 1. So I count all the students who are present. Then what I do is, if I have to calculate the absent, I will say absent is calculated as difference of total minus present. That should give you the number of students who are absent. So this I'm taking a normal day-to-day problem and trying to show you how the pseudocode approach is used. So if you have to take a look at the pseudocode approach, let's run through the logic here. So initially what I will do is I will say initialize a variable called as count to 0, absent to 0 and total to 50. This count will tell me how many students are present in the class. So initially it is 0 because we have not started counting yet. Absent is also 0 because we have not calculated absent, and total is 50. Then what I am going to do is, for every student or for each student in the class, I am going to increase the count by 1. So if I have to do it using pseudocode, this is what I will write. So I will say, for each student who is present, do the following. Let's see what the following is about. In the following, what I am going to do here is, I am going to say increase the count by 1. So step 2 is all about, for every student who is present, I am increasing the count by 1. Alright. Then the next step, what I am going to do is, I am going to say then subtract count from total. That means count from total, if I subtract, the result is going to be stored in absent and it is going to give me the number of students who are absent. Now finally, if I have to display the result, I am going to just say display the number of students who are absent. So here I am going to display in step 4 the number of students who are absent. So if you see the pseudocode approach, it is a very much English like way of trying to solve a problem. Suppose I had to solve it using an algorithm. An algorithm is between a programming language. It's a little higher than a programming language and a little lower than the normal spoken language, using a lot of arithmetic symbols. So let's see what is the algorithmic approach to solving this particular problem. Alright, so I just push this off. So the problem should still be clear to you. We have 50 students in the class and we want to know how many are absent. So in the algorithmic approach, just see how little I have written in English. I have just spoken as though I am doing some mathematical steps. So I am taking 3 variables. Count is initialized to 0, that is assigned to 0. This arrow symbol is assigned. Absent is assigned the value 0 and total is assigned the value 0. Then what I am going to say is, in step number 2, I am simply going to say in an English like manner, repeat till all the students are counted. That means I am going to say 1, 2, 3, 4 like this. So as I am counting each student, I am going to increase the count by 1. So this process of counting the students is going to continue till I have counted all the number of students who are present. At some point, the counting will be over. Now, in order to calculate the absentees, just see how I have done. In step 3, I have said absent is total minus count. And in the last step, I'm going to print the number of absent is absent. So here you can see it shows me the people who are absent. So if you compare, there are similar steps in both. This is much more English-like. This is a lot more closer to a programming language. So if you're discussing with a person who's not familiar with the programming language, use this approach. If you're wanting to write programs, first understand it or write it in this way, convert it into an algorithm, and then you can easily convert this into a program. Now, whenever you write the logic, whether it's a pseudocode or an algorithmic approach, it is important that you test it. Now, why is testing important? I'll tell you why. In testing, you should check for border conditions. Border conditions like means, suppose the class was empty. Will this logic work? Perfectly, it will work because it will show count as 0 and total is 50. So it will say absent as 50. Here if you see absent is 50 minus 0 is going to be 50. Now let's take an odd case. Suppose there were more than 50 present in the class. Then you are in a problem. Then it means either you are in the wrong class, okay, or it's a combined class, and then your logic, there is certain error, it's not going to work in this particular case. So you should be sure that whenever you test it with extreme conditions, conditions you think which may not normally occur, but more often than not, once they occur, the program tends to get into errors known as logical errors. So in order to avoid logical errors, always think of boundary conditions. Now here if you see, I was counting one student at a time. I can also count two students at a time. I can count three students at a time. I can count five students at a time. That way, my process of counting the total number of students is going to be faster. That particular thing is called as optimization in a algorithmic development. So in optimization, what do I end up doing here is, I, instead of counting from one student at a time, I can count two, I can count three, I can count four at a time, I can count five at a time, or I can count six at a time, depending how I am comfortable. Now you need to be careful. When you're counting, say, four at a time, suppose the number of students present is 43. Okay, so what will happen is here is, 4 into 10 is 40, then 3 remain at the last. You should be sure that you're looking for 4 into 10, but the remaining last 3 also should be added finally to this count variable. If you don't add it to the count, then you're going to count, or then you're going to get the total number of absent incorrect. So error is, when what an error can happen is, when you're counting more than one student at a time, like when you're counting 4 at a time, you may miss to count the last remaining students if your logic or your thought process is not clear. What I'm trying to say here is, suppose there are 44 students, okay, and I'm counting in multiples of 5. So till 40, no problem, because I'm getting a group of 5 each. But once I reach 40, there are only 4 remaining. I should not forget to add the 4 to the also to the count. Okay, that is an error which we tend to make while programming. So you should have proper logic to do that. Now you may think algorithms, programs, or pseudocode is something very, not very common. No. Examples of algorithm in daily life is, suppose you are making a certain dish. There is a particular step you follow. I give an example of making tea when I am discussing algorithms. So you need to follow certain steps while making dishes in your house. Any cooking item, whether it's your sambar, whether it's aloo paratha, there is a particular way of making these dishes. Now if you have seen dances in a lot of movies or things, the dance is not some random steps. There is a particular logic in the dance steps. Based on the song words, you repeat certain steps. So there is a particular sequence. So even dancing actually is an algorithmic approach. So I hope through this discussion, you have been able to have a clear differentiation between what exactly is a pseudocode and what exactly is the algorithmic approach. All right, this is important because we are going to write pseudocode first, followed by the algorithm, so that irrespective of how you are required to write the logic of a problem, you are very comfortable and you are able to give a solution.